So, well, let me ask you a question actually about this IPO. Success or potentially failure in that it's a small company that left a lot of money on the table?
Yeah, no, I think it's a success because I think what they're doing essentially is riding a wave, and you're going to see a lot more of these companies coming to market. So overall, there is the market is set up perfectly. You have a perfect confluence of events. They're 7 to 8 years old, these companies are. Revenues are growing 50% plus. So I think the market is rewarding them. If you can show good revenue growth in an addressable market that's huge, I think they get the benefit of doubt.
Love that deal and hate Uber and Lyft still.
Yeah, I mean, I want to take the other side of Uber and Lyft, okay. The glass half full side, because I think, for me, I think both these companies are teed up at the starting line pretty much. When Lyft came, did the IPO, there was an Uber overhang, so that pulled it back. When Uber did the IPO, there was turmoil, cross currents going on. So I think at this point, I think Uber has come to the starting line. Lyft plus or minus is around there, but we always felt that 62 to 68 was the right price for Lyft when we initiated coverage also. So I think overall these companies are right. Now they need to execute. Lyft did do a good job the first quarter in terms of revenue growth. Of course, their losses are growing, right. But they have a few years to prove that losses can be controlled. But at this point, it's about revenue growth. It's about market share. And these two companies they have time to prove themselves.
Okay, we have a couple of big ones still coming. WeWork is probably the biggest if you think that they're actually coming. And by the way, there are people who have questions even about that.
Sure.
Airbnb after that.
Yes.
They have cash on the balance sheet. Do they do a direct listing a la what Slack did and what Spotify did? I mean, I think there's some real questions here. And then you have the Pelotons in the world and a couple others.
Yeah. Airbnb is a good company. We like it. I think they have a good shot at doing a direct listing because they don't need the money. They've raised a lot of money and not used most of it. So, and the CEO has said that. So I think they're well positioned. They're in a good market. They have a pole position in that side of the market. And they're expanding also. They're not just staying with their core market. They're expanding right. Beyond that. Peloton, they have some issues. But again, these are niche players. If they can position themselves very well, the bankers right. can, I think they will do well as well.
By the way, you saw Postmates. Postmates is interesting because they're sort of in the Uber Eats business, effectively.
Right. But they have good relationships. I think the delivery business is going to come down to relationships in the end. Who do you, with the restaurants and other businesses. So I think these companies are right now, the market is big enough right. to address, take all of them. It's not a zero-sum game yet. So I think they will do well. Postmates will. So I think you'll see delivery companies, payment companies come to market, and they will do very well.
Andrew, what's the story with WeWork? What would cause them to pull back?
Well, I just think there's the potential for it to be delayed. I think there's the yes. real question in terms of when and if they go public.
Yeah.
This was a company that had a 40-plus billion-dollar valuation on it that today is being valued, at least in the private markets, at $23 billion.
Yeah, I think if they wait, it's going to get better.
Well, but I think there's a real question. If you go public mm-hmm. at a valuation that's half, what happens to, for example, SoftBank's investment? There is a view. If you're going to have to do effectively a public down round, right. that maybe you do want to wait if you think you can afford to wait. Yeah. I mean, that's the other piece of it, which is to say that WeWork is in a bit of a more complicated position because they're burning through cash.
Right. And it has a lot of risks around it. They haven't seen a bad market yet. The interest rates have been low. The companies are doing well. The leasing has been easy. So they're not held. There are no vacancies as such. So I think in that sense, they haven't been tested. You can say that it's a good time to get out while the market is still good. But on the other hand, there is risk down the road. So people are factoring that in. Right. There's a huge lease lease on the books, rather.
You think we'll see them as a public company in 2019?
I think you will because they can raise the money. They
had a valuation as high as what SoftBank put their money into.
No, I think it's lower based on my calculations. I think it is too high right,
you,
at this point.
What calculation? I mean, what number would you put it at?
I mean, I think closer to like 20 to 30 billion is where I think
that's half of where we of the last.
Yeah. See, I mean, these
money in.
These, yeah, like
these
47. Valuation.
47 was the
yeah.
last number.
Mm-hmm. So we really have. I mean, they've become a global player right now. So they have like the global dynamics playing into them.
Right.
So it's not just about U.S. So I mean, I guess you can make a case going there for 47 billion, but it's very high risk. At that point, you're priced for perfection totally, and you really execute. Totally.
Okay. Last question, real quick. This vintage, if we have this conversation 3 or 4 years from now. You're going to look back at this vintage of IPOs and think, great success. They're all doing quite well. You're going to look back and think we were just in 1999. What are you going to think?
No, I think this time it's different. These companies are good. They're real. The good products. They're really changing lifestyles. They're really changing our way of living. So I think they're here to stay. Okay.